I've had some insights and experience in the past, longer and shorter times, but I forget. And then there's in daily life this identification again with emotions, thoughts, and I've seen this beautiful light and felt this immense love and compassion, one of the big things that we all are. But I guess in the end, fear wins. Fear of the personality. Maybe you can say something about all this.
Your difficulty is quite understandable. If you had no forms, if you didn't have a body and a self, you wouldn't have the constant reflection back to you. You would be unstructured awareness. You have all of your forms enabling you to experience what you are in form. All of that form draws you into its structures. It necessarily draws you into an experience. It enables you to recognize your own beingness in your own movements. It works so well that it then is profoundly difficult to realize what you are in the midst of all of that. You have an entire nervous system drawing you away from the unseen beingness. That nervous system is affected very strongly by everything that touches it. That has you experiencing pleasure and pain, attraction and aversion. Once you have awakened to what is deeper than all of that, awakened to some sense within of what your source is, of what you've come from, some sense of what you are as a being. To sustain your awareness in that is also the retraining and the reteaching of your nervous system. Developing a self that is more like what you first are. Instead of just being in a self that is programmed to protect itself. For you to be what is deeper than your own nervous system, you'll be going against the experience of it. You'll be going against yourself. For you to be what you first are, you will be going against what yourself is. In yourself and in your own nervous system, you're programmed to protect the form you have. That programming has you then experiencing that that form is you. You're completely integrated into it. For you as awareness to recede into the deep and to be what you first are, you'll have a self that doesn't match that. You'll have a self that isn't like that. The self you have is a basic form of self. You have awareness of what's deeper in yourself and what's higher in yourself. But your practice isn't that. Without what's deeper in yourself and higher in yourself being integrated, you'll be locked into your basic personality in your basic experience of yourself.
But how can I integrate what I've experienced that I am?
By surrendering to being that. In the midst of a self that isn't like that. Whatever self you have, whatever kind of self you have, isn't really a problem. It's the form you have. For you to be what you first are, for you to be within yourself what you awaken to, puts you into profound difficulty. It has you realizing that for you to be functional in this world, in what you've awakened to, you need a different kind of self. You need a higher self and a deeper self than what yourself is like. The beingness of what you first are is different than your experience of your beingness that's most common in yourself. The beingness in yourself is driven by your nervous system. You're able, as awareness, to be what's different than that. But being that will be contrary to what your accustomed self is. It will be contrary to your own nervous system. The experience of your nervous system being agitated, agitated by pleasure or by pain, strongly distracts you from the profound beingness that are levels deeper. The self you have and its structuring demands your attention. It demands that you not be a higher self or a deeper self. Your efforts to be a higher self or a deeper self has you then, as an accustomed self, being in reaction to yourself. It confirms the very thing that you're trying to get away from. Trying to be a different self, trying to be a higher self or a deeper self, has you then being even more like what your accustomed self is, your everyday self. It has you in yourself being in a state of reaction against your own self. It has you experiencing the opposite of what you do in your heart long to be. Instead of looking to change something in yourself, surrender your own awareness to the realization of something of what you are within that has you accessing a gentle beingness within a nervous system that isn't like that. That has you then been rested. Rested in your heart. Despite having a nervous system that is constantly being agitated by the positive and the negative. what you'll be developing then is a different kind of heart than what yourself is like. That has you being more aware of your heart than yourself. In that, it isn't difficult to have an open and a soft heart in the midst of a self that seems and feels closed and hard. That has you moving in your own beingness, a deeper beingness. When you are as awareness, surrendering to opening and softening within, that has you coming into a softer and a more open heart, within which you'll experience more of a brokenness, a vulnerability, where you're easily affected from within that openness and softness by things that agitate yourself. Instead of having a strength in your person, you become more acquainted with the fineness and the weakness of being. In yourself, you're programmed to relate to strength. In your being, you naturally move as a very fine and tender weakness, where you don't have the need of strength. In yourself, you need the strength. But in needing that strength to be functional in a difficult world, that also tends to change your orientation, where you believe that deeper within, you also need to be the same. That kind of orientation distracts you from the openness and the softness, your basic, deeper beingness. So that you keep experiencing what is like a split within, where you've been awakened to a deeper kind of beingness, or awakened to what's even deeper than that. And that is a knowledge of what you are, a knowledge of oneness. You're able to be what you first are, with its beingness, in the midst of the kind of self you have, without first trying to change yourself in order for you to be that. Being that in the midst of the kind of self you have does change yourself. But your focus as awareness cannot be that of needing to change yourself. You just simply cannot trust or refer to your experience of yourself to tell you what you are, to tell you the truth within. You're liking knowing the truth within enables you to be coming from that. Liking knowing what you've awakened to in the midst of your present self, in the midst of a self that isn't like that.